Welcome to the Mischief, I'm Vallen, and this is Tinker's Construct 2. I'll be covering today all the tools and weapons that you can make with the tool station, and the different abilities that each one will have. If you're looking for modifiers and special materials, we'll be covering that in a different video. So where to begin with all this stuff? There's quite a bit you can make with just the Tier 1 weapons and tools here in your tool station. Not to be confused with the tool forge over there, which is made with some kind of metals. This one here is strictly made with wood, including, in the newest versions, a short bow. Plus, there's a longbow and a crossbow and shuriken, but those are all going to be in the tool forge among other really advanced tools and weapons. But we're going to start off with these ones. There's a few changes and a few new items as well. So first and foremost, these tools are fairly indestructible. I throw one in here in the fire, you see it's still burning. That is just a wooden mattock. It is perfectly fine, untouched. And if I throw it in the lava, nothing happens. It just bounces off. You see there, it just keeps bouncing around. So these are fairly indestructible. You can lose them in the void, or if you put them in another container and that container is destroyed, it is possible that they could be destroyed in that fashion. Or if you just put them in some kind of other mods, like trash can or something, that is another way that you could feasibly destroy these. But you might, the good thing is that you can upgrade these. As shown in the previous video, you can actually upgrade these tools with just by replacing the individual parts of each one. So let's start at the beginning. We'll work our way around and cover a whole bunch of these new tools and items after I cover a few basics that apply to pretty much all of them. First was, of course, they're indestructible. The other is the fact that you have offhand harvestability. What that means is, as you see here, I have a pick in my shield slot here, and I have a mattock in my regular hand here. And therefore, if I right-click on this stone, you'll see nothing happens. But if I left-click, I will start mining it with the pick. Now, if I go over to the grass and left-click, I will start mining with the more appropriate tool, which is going to be the mattock. Now, if I right-click, I will use the mattock's ability to till the earth, but I'm not using the pick. If I try using the pick, you know, or switching over, I just try digging it with the appropriate tool. So as you can see here, just holding the left click and scrolling back and forth, I'm alternating the different types of abilities for these two tools. So you can actually go mining with stone and dirt tools, digging tools, very easily, as well as a few other possible combinations. And then, of course, we've got sharpening kits. These are used for multiple things. First and foremost is to upgrade or downgrade the harvesting levels. So if I look at this wooden pickaxe here, it says here, mining level stone, which that means that if I apply a sharpening kit with a flint, I can increase or decrease its mining level. So I would be able to only harvest, let's say, let's say I put a obsidian sharpening kit on there. I would be able to then harvest up to and including obsidian type materials, even though it's a wooden pick. It would be entirely slow, but it would be doable. And if I wanted to downgrade that, I could put a flint and a sharpening kit on there of a different level, let's say a wooden one, and therefore downgrade it back to where it was. Now there is another use for sharpening kits, but before I get into that, let's show you how to repair these. If you have something that is broken or it is currently damaged, let's see here, actually I'm going to try tilling the earth here, till a few spots. There we go, that is now damaged as well. If I come over here and I get a little bit of wood, I put three pieces in there because I know it's going to take two to replace this wooden arrow, but this wooden arrow is broken, so it can be repaired and it's good as new. Now if I take this wooden mattock, just one should get it back to normal, and this is just partially damaged. Now on top of that, if I have a sharpening kit, there we go, some wooden sharpening kits, and I therefore get the, let's see, get some durability loss going on this wooden mattock here. I can now repair it with just the sharpening kit on the go. I don't need to carry around a tool station with a piece of flint or anything like that, but that is the basic gist of using the sharpening kits and how they can benefit you with, well, basically just making your life easier, keeping a couple items in your hand, keeping a stack of the appropriate sharpening kit that matches the head of the tool or weapon in your inventory or in a storage bag, and then you can repair it as you travel along. So let's start with your most normal pick, your pickaxe right here. Now I'm just using wooden examples of all of these ones because, like I said, I'm not getting into the materials or the modifications today. That will be a separate episode. But if you see here, you've got the anvil. If you choose the item, it then shows you all the items that you need. It will have a list on the side and tell you, highlighting which items you may or may not need. You can also name the tool up here if you so desire, so that you can have your own specialized pickaxe or whatever tool or weapon you want. Now, what do pickaxes do differently here in Tinkers? Not really much. They are just upgradable. And that's pretty much it. They function exactly the same as a regular pickaxe does in vanilla Minecraft, but they can have their parts replaced, upgraded, modifications and materials added on, so it can be very modifiable now, or modular even. Now, getting into the shovel, there actually is a change here. And allow me to demonstrate. You've got your binding, a tool rod, and a shovel head. Each one of these tools is going to have different material costs, and they might actually be slightly more expensive as far as quantity versus the vanilla costs of these, but usually the ends justify the means, because you'll get either a lot more durability or functionality or even upgradability out of these tools. So, a wooden shovel, or just any of the shovels in this case. Of course, it's good on dirt, sand, gravel, and snow, as a normal shovel would be, but if you right-click, it will turn grass into a path, like so. And now I'm clicking on the dirt. It does not work on dirt or the tilled earth, only works on grass and can make the new vanilla pathways here, which actually mobs don't spawn on, so that's something to keep in mind if you want to till the earth around your base. You can therefore try and make it a little bit more mob safe. So, moving on from the shovel, you can then also get an axe, or a hatchet in this case. I'm just going to put it in my offhand at this point. But it's good on wood and leaves. Ah, now you're seeing where it's beneficial in this case. With that in mind, it also has no durability loss for leaves. So, let me get over here to a tree and demonstrate. Just for the ease of this, I have actually removed the shovel from my other hand. You can see, you know, it chops wood just fine. It's a wooden hatchet. But if I, and I had also took some durability loss. See, it's down to 73 or 75. Now, if I use it on tree leaves, it actually works much faster than if I were to use my regular hand. And of course, different levels would be even better. And with that, the durability has stayed the same, so it's still 73. So you're not losing anything in this, and you could also gain the benefits of getting the saplings. As you saw there, saplings are still dropping, and you can use it to clear trees and their leaves much quicker. So that's a little bit of a benefit as well. And of course, that is made with a wooden axe head, wooden tool rod, and a wooden binding. Well, I guess the parts don't all have to be wooden, but you get the idea. At least the axe head, binding, and tool rod are required to make a hatchet. Now, we've got the combination here, and this one is always actually brought forth a lot of controversy. This is the mattock here. It actually has two heads on it and one tool rod. It has a shovel and an axe head, and it's good on wood and dirt, not grass, and some plants. It also tills earth like a vanilla hoe. Now that's really what this is. It's just a really good hoe. Your vanilla Minecraft hoes, and how they're extremely useless except for just tilling the earth, and that's just about it. Well, this one really does the opposite of that and makes it very useful because it has two heads on it. It actually will gain extra attack damage on this. So if you compare a wooden mattock here, 5.5 attack damage, to a wooden broadsword, 4 attack damage, you can see already that it has potential to be a very good early game weapon for you. So don't overlook the mattock. Now, it is slightly slower than a hatchet as far as cutting wood, but it's kind of a multi-purpose tool here. And you can see here, I can till the earth with it just like I normally would. I can dig earth just fine, but once I get into digging grass, it's very slow, though it is still faster than if I were to dig the grass with my hands. And here we have the frying pan, which is simply a pan and a tool rod put together. We'll get you the wooden frying, or a frying pan, not necessarily wooden in this case. I just used wooden. Anyway, moving on, it has a couple abilities here. It is a two-handed item. So for example, if I have a shield and this, you'll notice that I'm winding it back instead of using the shield, so I drop the shield. Now, looking at my character, it looks like I'm kind of drawing it like a bow. So it actually has a different ability, and it's kind of heavy that way. So therefore, you won't be able to gain the benefits per se of some of your offhand items. Sometimes you will, but not necessarily a shield at least. Now, if you use a right click, you saw that animation where I was pulling it back and then I release it. If there is a target nearby, like a spider, and I use it on him, it causes severe damage to him. Of course, this is just a wooden pan, and you have to time it just right to gain the benefit from it. But when you do so, you'll gain bonus damage. You will also cause a knockback effect, which this has a knockback automatically on it. So if I just strike this guy, then he gets a knockback anyway, plus that wonderful, satisfying frying pan sound. And you notice it took a lot more hits than it did before when I was using the bonus where I kind of wind it up and then give him a good whack. Now here's the really cool part. If I get some chickens and I use that attack on a chicken, it kills the chicken and has the potential chance to cook the contents of it if I killed it with that bonus wind up. Now it doesn't work 100%. As you saw there, I had two examples where, oh, and he got away, there you go, where it didn't work, but sometimes it does. Well, that's just kind of the cool thing. Plus, you get that really satisfying sound. All right, moving on from the frying pan, we have come to the battle shield. This is really, really good, or battle sign, excuse me. Well, it technically is a shield, but it's one that you can actually use to fight with. It's simply just, you know, a wooden sign plate with a wooden tool rod, so it's very simple and easy to make. I actually recommend you make one of these first thing because it's easier to come by than your vanilla shield. The reason being, recipe for this is wood plus an iron ingot. Often you haven't got an iron ingot straight away at the beginning, whereas you could feasibly make a wooden battle sign straight out of wood, flint, cactus, whatever pleases you at this point. And they're very fun, actually, a lot better than one might think nowadays. So it works like a shield, and you can see I currently am holding one here like a sign, is even though it looks like I have two shields on. When you look at your character, you can see here that it kind of is weird. It's like I'm kind of smacking myself in the face. But it does work like a shield, and in fact, you can put it in your shield slot easily and use it with, let's say, a sword, and you can use it to block just like a shield would and attack with your sword. So if I replace that, here, let me put that on my hotbar, you can see that, you know, it acts very similarly to my the shield that I had before. And here's the fun part, is that you can use this as a really good melee weapon. So if you instead don't want to make a sword, you could make a battle shield and just use it to attack with. If you see there, you've got the refresh speed like I'm swinging a weapon, or you can use it to defend. And in this case, it's got some extra stuff. First and foremost, it will reflect arrows. Secondly, if you block a melee attack with it, you'll actually do the equivalent of punching the enemy with your hand back at them. So it's not just going to block the damage, you also do a little bit of damage back to them. All right, so I have some skeletons here. Let's see if I can make it nighttime and test this out. There we go, a little quick snack of some chicken. And if I spawn a skeleton here, he's gonna want to try and shoot me eventually. There we go. And here's the advantage of this, is that you bounce arrows back in the direction you're aiming. So if I aim over here, you see the arrow that he shoots at me goes over there, and over there, and so on. So you can actually target this directly back at your attacker and have a really good time playing ping pong or just sending that pain back at them. Now if I have a spider coming at me and I use my shield, you see he's taking damage by trying to attack me, and I'm deflecting all damage away from me. Now this doesn't work for deflecting all projectiles. I mean, if you try fighting the wither, you're going to be, well, damaged by the wither. If you try and deflect your ghast fireballs in 110 and not 111, then your shield... There, I'm going to start attacking him with it now. Your shield will... There we go. It's block some of the damage, and the explosion will still happen in the current version if a ghast attacks you. But currently, a battle sign doesn't necessarily do a lot of damage. You can see it's plus 2.72 in comparison to like a sword is plus 4, and of course your matic is 5.5, so it only does about like 1.25 hearts of damage to the enemy if you actually hit them with it, whereas it is a really good blocking ability though. So you could effectively take this as a shield with a sword, and you know, just your first wooden setup and you'll be good to go. And so your first skeletons you come across, you'll be more than adequate to take them out. Now just to demonstrate this further, I now have a regular shield in my hand and not the battle sign. As you can see here, I've got my little mischief of my sign battle here, and let's bring him up, and I'm gonna have this guy attack me. You can see the arrows just kind of bounce downwards. He has to be really darn close for these arrows to actually hit him. And often they'll just go over my head if he's a really bad archer. But you can see that there's a big disadvantage to this. Because I have to really get close to him, and he's hiding around a corner. So it's definitely worthwhile to get a battle sign instead of a regular shield. But then again, you can't make them look as cool as these other ones can. Now here's the bad part. That my shield has broken. You can see that actually the top left corner there is gone. But here's the good part, is that it still acts like a regular vanilla shield, even though it's broken. As you can see, the arrows are currently just bouncing off and falling at a very low area, and I have to fight this guy in a normal fashion. Alright, so as you saw there, I was actually using the broadsword, which is simply made, well, let's see if we can get it here, with a sword blade, a wide guard, and a tool rod put together to give you your broadsword. And this has a special ability similar to the vanilla sword, which is it has a sweeping attack if you have an enemy nearby. But you have to actually have the crosshairs over them for at least a split second before you swing, or else you won't get that swing attack. Now, it also is a one-handed weapon, so it should be usable with other tools and weapons. For instance, I can, swing here. And this may look weird, but watch. I'm actually going to till the earth with the sword. It's just part of how Tinkers is set up right now. It still works just fine, so there's nothing wrong with it. Basically, you're using the ability of the hoe, even though the animation happens for the sword. So if I, switch hands there, then it kind of gets a little bit weird, but you just deal with what you've got here. And we've got a friend here, so let's see if we can convince him to show off the sweeping attack. There you go, the normal sweeping attack, just like in vanilla with other swords there. It should be noted that you also get a slight sweeping knockback effect from hitting the enemy as well. As you can see, he's getting pushed back. It is very slight, but noticeable. Alright, next up we have the longsword, which is made in a very similar fashion with a sword blade and a tool rod, but in the center there it's going to have a handguard. Now this is a very offensive weapon, and I don't mean like you're going to get insulted by it. I mean more, it's going to do more damage, but not at lower tier materials. So if you look here, the attack damage on this broadsword is plus 4. the longsword is plus 3.75. But as you get into higher and higher metals and materials, it will actually change over where the wooden long, or not the wooden, the longsword will actually be much more damaging in attack damage. Well, not a lot, but a little. But it is also considered kind of a two-handed weapon. The reason I say that is because while I may be able to carry a shield, if I click the right button, it doesn't do it. You know, the shield just sits there. So if I hold the right button, though, I charge an attack where I lunge forward with this sword. Hui! And let's see if I show you guys here. Now, it shows from someone else's perspective that I'm using the sign or a shield, but it's actually the sword. And you can see it actually made me jump forward. I was not moving there. All that was just a right click. So if I use my left click, I then attack as well. And it does normal attack sword damage as if I was fighting a little beastie here. You see, just I get a sweeping attack like the broadsword does. And I get to kill the enemies just the same. Alright, enough with the sweeping attacks and everything. We've got the rapier, which is really interesting. You've got your sword blade, you've got your tool rod, and you've got your cross guard. So the weapon changes a bit. This is very spammy. The reason I say that is because, well, here, let's once again look at the attack speed of the broadsword is 1.6. The longsword is 1.4, which also helps justify the higher damage later on. And the rapier, attack speed is 3. It's almost double that of the other ones. And its attack damage, though, is about half. So it's for those people that are used to, like, Minecraft 1.7 or just really liked the rapiers. You can just kind of, you know, as fast as you can click the button, most of the time, you should be able to swing this sword. Now, it also has 50% armor penetration, which can be very helpful. So that will actually increase its damageability in comparison to the others against armored targets. Now, it also does low damage, as I said, but it is a two-handed weapon similar to the longsword, where it does not have a functionality for, like, your shield because it has a secondary ability. It has a dodge back ability. Now, if I use this, you see it actually looks like I've kind of got it in a stabbing motion, but when you look at the characters, it looks like I'm just holding it regular. Now, if I use this and I hold the right click, I start just instantly jumping backwards. It's really interesting. That wasn't me jumping or moving backwards. It just instantly happens. It's a dodge effect. So while you're charging somebody, you can attack them with the sword, and you can see how fast this thing can attack now. It's pretty good. But let's finish off this spider as fast as I can hit him. You can see I was doing not very much damage, but I was also able to hit him over and over and over again. And then if he were to be attacking me and I needed to get away, often backing up is rather slow. You can use this to back up even quicker and get out of a battle very quickly. And here we are, what everybody has been waiting for. Bows are back in Tinker's Construct. That's right. And this is just going to be the short bow. I'm not covering the long bow or the crossbow today. But these are simply made with a couple of bow limbs and some bow string. And the arrow is, whoops, that's not even the arrow. The arrow is made with an arrow shaft, a fletching, and an arrow head. And of course, those all change how everything works with these tools, or rather, weapons, I should say. Now, I did grab some for comparison's sake here. I have a wooden short bow and a vanilla bow. I also have some arrows, and I have a flint arrow, which actually I should switch these around. There we go. So, the good thing about this is that, well, a short bow is faster movement. So, if I am keeping this pulled back, you can see I'm moving forward at a pretty slow pace, but in comparison to a vanilla bow, I'm moving much, much faster when I have the short bow up. So it is really different on your maneuverability. You can move around quite a bit more than you can with a vanilla bow. So that is something to keep in mind. The other thing is, it has a little bit less damage. This is a short bow. A vanilla bow is considered to be the equivalent of a long bow. The damage is going to be a little bit less, but it is much, much faster. And as with both short bows and long bows, you can actually use let's just take this Tinker's arrow out of here. So I only have vanilla arrows in my inventory. And you can see that it actually puts a vanilla arrow in the Tinker's bow. I can use those, but they're going to be very, less effective. You can see that the accuracy on these is pretty good, because most vanilla ones are. But if I attack a target, you see I've got damage 4, 5.5, 4.5, 5, and so on. And it'll be lessened in comparison. Now, I made a flint arrow, which cost like 2 flint to make the head, 2 sticks, or 2 pieces of wood to make the arrow shaft, and 2 feathers to make the fletching. For that, you would only get 8 arrows. Now, in this case, I got 15, so therefore, reduced damage isn't too bad. Now, if I start shooting at this target here, you can see that I'm able to shoot pretty darn quick with this thing, and it's fairly accurate with how it is currently set up, and the damage on it is less than if I were using the vanilla equivalent. Now, if I use a vanilla bow, you can see I'll shoot over here at this one. It takes longer to wind it up and shoot these targets, but there is a slight difference with the accuracy on this one at least. No, it doesn't appear to actually be showing up. But, I mean, this is all just wooden. I am not switching out any kind of modifiers or materials. I do have some flint arrows in here, so that's not too much to worry about. But it's really, really good. These are very customizable. All these tools and weapons start out with 3 modifiers and can be increased more with others. So, with that, that's pretty much it for now. I mean, I know that I really enjoy... Let's actually aim a little higher so I can hit the center of the target here. I really do enjoy this. There's a ton more to come, folks, that we can get through. Next up, we're probably going to be covering the tool forge and some of the advanced tools and weaponry that come along with that. So, I hope you guys enjoyed today. Don't forget to give a like if you enjoyed this video. Comment down below. I'd like to hear what you have to say. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And spread the mischief to others if you think they'll enjoy the content. Until next time, folks, I'll see ya.